Yeah, hello students. Now we are learning the second part of this same experiment. Okay, as in first part we have discussed how to determine the resistance of galvanometer by half deflection method. Now we are learning the second part, that is to find the figure of merits. Now this part is very easy. You can check it out, the circuit diagram. If you compare these two circuit diagram, only this part is not there in this circuit diagram. So we have removed this part from our circuit. Okay, and everything, all the connections are same as we did over here in first. You can check it out, the connection. Okay, from positive of the battery, okay, it is connected to the resistance. Then other terminal of resistance is connected to galvanometer, and galvanometer is connected to the battery through this key K1. So there is only one key. You can check it out over here. There is only one key in this whole circuit. Here, this is the first table to find the resistance of galvanometer, and we have calculated this resistance of galvanometer. We got the value of resistance by taking the mean of all the readings, that is 190 ohm. So this value we have to use it in this calculation, okay, in this to find the figure of merit of the galvanometer. Now what is the procedure? Now here in this first column we are not using, because we are not using the different cells. Okay, so I'll just remove this first column. Now we are having directly EMF of the cell. As you can check it out on the battery, it has been written 0, 2, 4, 6 volt. So we have kept this 2 volt constant. So we have to write first, this is of what, 2 volt. Now the method is, first you have to take out the resistance, some resistance, so that the deflection should be as maximum as possible. You can check out, okay, here I have kept 2000 plus 2000 plus 500, so total 4500 ohm resistance. And if I switch on the battery, can check it out, the galvanometer shows maximum reading. It is approx 27. So I have kept 4500 ohm resistance and I am getting the reading 27. This is what the way of taking the reading. Now what we will do, we will change the values of resistances. Accordingly, we'll get the different values of deflection, and with these values, as you can check that E is a 2 volt, it is constant for all the readings. R, this is R, this is G, this is G 190, and this theta is this deflection 27. So by taking all the different readings, approx 4 or 5 readings we will take, that I'll send you in a PDF form. Okay, you will get the different values or approximately same values of figure of merit. Again, we will take mean value of that, and we can write the figure of merit value in ampere per division. So at last we will write the result, that the resistance of given galvanometer is obviously 190 ohm, which we will get it, which we got it in first part, and the second one, figure of merit, whichever, we will get it over here. Yeah, thank you so much.